Hello everyone, and welcome to this presentation. My name is Ivan Stepanov. I work as a system simulation engineer at the company Valeo, doing LiDA simulation in virtual environments. And in this presentation, I will tell you how you can use IPG CarMaker FreeSpace Sensor Plus to generate synthetic LiDAR data. So this is the outline of the presentation. First, I will give you an overview of what the FreeSpace Sensor Plus can do, what kind of output it can provide, and what are the limitations of the sensor. Then we can discuss how we can calculate the intensity of light from the output of FreeSpace Sensor Plus. And then we can discuss some optical and electrical effects like blooming and different electrical effects on the time-resolved waveform. Then we can discuss the semantic segmentation, how it can be achieved using this setup, and how it can be used. So let me give you a short overview of Valeo, the company I'm working for. It is a French company with over 100,000 employees, of which almost 20,000 are working in the R&D. It is distributed over 140 countries and is divided in four business groups. There is visibility systems, powertrain systems, thermal systems, and driving and comfort and driving assistance systems. And I am part of this last group, comfort and driving assistance systems. And on this slide, you can see an overview of different products that are developed on our site in Bietigheim. There is automatic parking systems, which is a product Park4U. And there are automated driving systems, which are Cruise4U and Drive4U. And here you can see an overview of different sensors which are developed or used at our site in Bietigheim. We have rain humidity sensors, we have ultrasonic sensors, cameras, radar, and LiDAR sensors. And for almost all of the sensors, like the ultrasonic, front camera, radar sensors, and LiDAR sensors, we're developing sensor models based on IPG CarMaker in cooperation with IPG. So why do we want to develop all the sensor models, and why do we want to generate synthetic LiDAR data and not use real LiDAR data? So first reason is virtual validation. We want to do a lot of the tests in the virtual world and not in the real world to save costs, because it's much cheaper to run this test in a simulation. Then we can generate a lot of data which is automatically annotated and use this data for training of neural networks or for development of algorithms. Then we can generate scenarios which are not available in the real data because they were just missed during the recording of real data, or because these scenarios we want to simulate are too dangerous, because we, for example, want to simulate an accident, which is very, very difficult in the real world. And we can use the simulation to support development of new sensors and algorithms. So if a new sensor is developed and the data cannot be generated yet, we can use simulation to estimate its future performance, and we can already generate some data to support the development of algorithms for this new sensor. So let me give you an overview what the FreeSpace Sensor Plus looks like. On the left, you can see the output of this FreeSpace Sensor Plus. You can see this red squares, which show you the detections in CarMaker. And this sensor is relatively performant because it runs on the GPU. And for each of these points, we can get distance, material ID, object ID, and the incidence angle or the surface normal of the objects we were hitting. The sensor, however, has some limitations. It doesn't calculate the intensity. We have to do it ourselves. There is no time-resolved waveform which is usually present in a real sensor, and there is no optics simulation. So the sensor is very basic. However, I would argue that we can use this output as a basis for some very detailed sensor simulations. And this is what we'll discuss in the next slides. So first we will discuss how we can calculate the intensity of the signal from this data. Basically, in CarMaker, we have our scene, and if we sample this scene with our sensor, we will get the detections. We can see this in this point cloud. We will get for each point the distance, material ID, and incidence angle. And using these three information together, we can calculate the intensity, which you can see here as different colors. And you can see that here red means very high intensity because it is very close to the sensor, and the incidence angle is right. And moving far away from the sensor, the signal decreases. To calculate the intensity of the return signal, we're using the distance, which is simply 1 over distance squared. We use a custom material library where different materials can have different reflectivity properties. Let's say asphalt will reflect relatively little light, while car paint will reflect a lot of light. And we can use the incidence angle to model the reflective properties of this material. If we have a surface normal of the object and the incident ray, we can calculate the angle of incidence, or it is already calculated by CarMaker in the newer versions. And with this angle, we can calculate the intensity dependent on this angle. So we can model the diffuse part and the specular part, this sharp peak. And we can do this using any model you want. You can use the Blinfeng model, which is common in computer graphics, or you can use the BRDF model. And with this, we can model different materials like car paint, which will have some diffusive and some specular components. And we can have materials like retroreflective materials. And now using this intensity calculation, we want to construct the signal that the sensor is usually generating. So in the real world, there are a lot of photons which are hitting the LiDAR sensor, and each photodiode will be affected by a large number of photons. And to simulate this effect, we construct this very high resolution intensity image of our scene, and then we collect the relevant pixels which will be affecting one photodiode, and we integrate the signals of all these pixels to generate the signal that our real LiDAR sensor would see in a complex world. So each photodiode is not only affected by one pixel in the simulation, but it can be affected by several hundreds of pixels. So what we do with these pixels is we construct the time-resolved waveform signal. Let's say we have a road paint on asphalt. This is a road paint. And each of the points will contribute a small Gaussian peak to the overall complex LiDAR waveform signal. So X is the time, Y is the voltage. And here you can see that the signal from asphalt is decaying with distance. And on top of it, we have a relatively sharp peak from the road paint. And the signal can be very complex. Then you can apply noise to the signal. You can apply a threshold. And you can get the detected distance, you can get peak positions, and you can get overall power of these peaks, or you can get the pulse width from this complex waveform signal. And the idea is to reproduce the actual electrical signal that would be processed inside of your sensor. We can also have multiple reflections using this approach. And in this case, our pixel is seeing the car, this reflection, then it sees the guard rail, these two peaks, and it can see the trees in the background, which is the last peak. And if you apply a threshold, you will detect several peaks, and then you can use your algorithms to select one of the peaks. The next effect we want to discuss is the illumination and sensitivity profile. So if this is your high resolution intensity map, then you can simulate that only some portions of this field of view are illuminated by the laser illumination profile. Let's say you have some stripes that illuminate the scene, and you can simulate the sensitivity profile of the photodiode. Let's say you have some central area which is highly sensitive, and around it you have an area which is much less sensitive, and both areas contribute to the signal. And these areas of different photodiodes can even overlap. And you can define the sensitivity profile of your real photodiodes, which you can model, or which you can take from real measurements. And with this, you can simulate effects like blooming, where a pixel will be affected by a strong signal, even if the source of the signal is not directly inside the field of view. For example, if a highly reflective traffic sign generates a lot of signal, this signal will be kind of overflowing into the neighboring pixels. Then you can implement complex scanning patterns using this approach. We know that some LiDAR sensors have very complicated scanning patterns where the beam is not just traveling from left to right, but instead traveling in complex paths. And this is something that you can simulate with this approach, where you can take your sensitivity profile and just apply it to different portions of this high resolution map. And then from each portion, you will get your signal at the corresponding angles. And here you can see the flow diagram of such a sensor model. It starts with this ideal point cloud with a very high resolution, where we only have the intensity for each point. Then we calculate the optical time resolved signal, we generate the electrical signal, we generate effects like blooming and beam pass. From this, we calculate the time resolved waveform signal, the electrical signal. We calculate effects like saturation, noise, and so on. And then using this signal, we apply a threshold and calculate the distance, pulse width, or power of these peaks. And this should result in a realistic, detailed point cloud, which you can see here. And in addition to this realistic signal, we can also get automatic segmentation by object ID. So in theory, we lose this information because we construct this time-resolved waveform signal, where the object ID gets lost. It is no longer present in the signal, but using some tricks and knowing which points have contributed to the signals, we can still recover this information about the object ID, and then we can generate a lot of automatically segmented LiDAR data, and we can use this data to train neural networks. We can validate segmentation algorithms, or we can support their development, and we can use this data for some general object detection algorithm analysis. So, for example, if you want to know if some object is detected at specific resolution or not, you can simply count the points. So let me summarize this presentation. I hope I could show you that you can use the CarMaker FreeSpace Sensor Plus as a basis for very detailed sensor simulations. You can simulate different effects of the LiDAR sensor, like time absorbed waveform, illumination and sensitivity profiles, and different scanning patterns. And you can even generate automatically annotated signals from this. This approach has some limitations. It is very difficult to achieve real time because there is a bottleneck between the GPU and the CPU, leading to relatively long calculation times. And it is not based on ray tracing, so we cannot have secondary reflections and we cannot have transparent materials. So for this, you would need to use a different sensor. So if you want to ask me some questions or you have some suggestions, there is something I have missed, you can contact me at ivan.stepanov@valeo.com. And thank you for your attention.